Manscaped 3.5 is finally out, and in today's video, I'm going to be overviewing some of my favorite new features. So I'm going to be showing you the new adjustable asset series, the improved lighting and reflections, 3D people assets, alpha channel export improvements, orthographic view updates for Revit, and then most importantly, running Manscaped in new Revit 2024. Let's go. Now, if you want to check Manscaped out, you can get a free 30-day trial if you follow the first link down in the description of this video and then also up in the cards above. And now I'm going to be showing you all of my favorite new features. And full disclosure, this is a sponsored video. So now, without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. And here we are in Revit, and I have this Manscaped sample project. So if I just open up Manscaped, as you can see here, I already have Manscaped running. So if I just open it up here, you can see this is what that project looks like in Manscaped. And now let's get started with talking about the new assets. So we have over 1,000 new adjustable assets. So what does this mean? Well, it means that we can, well, as the name would imply, we can adjust assets. So let me show you here. Let's say I want to add an additional car here. So I'm just going to go here to the asset library, and then I'm going to search for vehicles. And now here in the vehicles, I'm just going to pick out the tab adjustable. So this is going to filter out all of the non-adjustable vehicles. And now I can pick out one of these. So for example, this car here, and then let's just place it here, just like that. And then I'm going to select it and just adjust its rotation and position. Now we can say that this works. Okay, so now once we have this car here in place, I can then select it. So if I go back to the select tool, I can select the car. And then when I click on the car, here we have the material adjustment. So now you can actually customize the color of this car. So if you want it to be kind of a dark blue car, you can adjust it. And now, as you can see, it's a dark blue car. However, if you want to change that, so let's say I want a bright yellow car. Now this can be a bright yellow car. So you can play around with the colors, and I think it's really cool to have this adjustment, just because sometimes you might have kind of the make of the car that you're looking for, but it's not in the right color. And well, now you no longer have that issue. You can adjust that. Now we can also insert a bike here. So for example, in this case, we have two variants. So let's say I want to go with this variant, and then I'm just going to place it over there. And then let's kind of go to that bike. And now we can adjust its color as well. So now if I just pick out or select that bike, I can come here and then I can change the material. So if I want this to be a bright blue bike, I can adjust it. If I want it to be, I don't know, let's say we want a pink bike, well, now we have a pink bike. And then I'll just apply those changes. So it's going to load in all of those elements into the model at the kind of set colors. Moving forward, and I might want to go inside for this one. So let's enter this cafe that we have here. So this looks nice. And then let's kind of take a seat here. And now I can tell you about the new improved lighting and reflections. So now there is a global illumination algorithm which delivers enhanced lighting, reflections, and rendering quality to users with GPUs that support hardware accelerated ray tracing. So what that means is that we have a better quality of indirect lighting, especially in interior scenes such as this one. We have a more realistic, high quality visualizations, and we have consistent lighting and precise shading in mirrored reflections. This feature is, however, available only to users which use NVIDIA RTX and AMD RX 6000 or 7000 series graphics cards. So you will definitely be able to see an improvement in just the quality of rendering in the latest version of Manscaped. Now let's go back to assets, because you love Manscaped assets. And what I want to show you now is the 3D people. So here, if I go to Manscaped assets, let's just filter this down to people. And then what we're going to do is go here to the tag. And then here we have exclusive. So we have 93 exclusive people. And let's pick out one. So let's pick out this lad here and place him here in the cafe, just kind of thinking about things. And now if I select him like this, what you'll see is here, if I click on this icon here, I can now change his outfit. So we can play around with the outfits of our people, which we place here. So I think green is nice. So it kind of fits in with all of the greenery that we have here in this cafe. So I'm just going to leave him like this, standing there in his nice green sweater. And then let's apply these changes as well. And as you saw, there is 93 of these types of kind of 3D people where you can adjust the assets. Just make sure to use that exclusive tag to filter down to the people where you can change the clothes. Then we have some new improvements in terms of the alpha channel export. So basically, alpha channel export means that your background essentially can be removed. So you can export out of Enscape and just have no background. If you don't want to use this sky, for example, and you want to leave that kind of for post-production and leave that for Photoshop, you can export with the alpha channel. So if I go here to our visual settings and go to output, we have the alpha channel or apply alpha channel available. So what this will do is it will just export the image without the background, and with the new improvements, this will also work really well with the transparent surfaces. So if you have something made out of glass, it will just kind of export that, and when you put a new background behind it, the kind of glass effect will still be visible there. So some big improvements there as well. Then we have the orthographic views update for Revit. So if you want to create some orthographic views, so if I go here and let's change this to orthographic, just like this, I can now create orthographic views and I can save them, and it will work basically in Revit. So if I'm happy with this particular view that they have here, I can go here and create a view. I can call it Enscape 3D View 1 Test. Okay, and let's create that view. And once this view has been created, it should appear here, and here it is. So now if I go back into Revit, here in the 3D views, we should have that view. Okay, here it is. So if I just open it up here, as you can see, this view will work. It's even cropped. So if I turn on the crop region, so it's cropped according to Enscape, and well, it's also created the same view. So we have this support. And now if we make some changes to the view in Revit, it will update in Enscape. So it's completely connected. And then most importantly, what you'll notice here is I am using Revit 2024. So we have Enscape support for Revit 2024. So you can use the latest version of Revit and the latest version of Enscape to get the best results. And that's going to conclude my top favorite features for Enscape 3.5. Again, as I said, if you want to check out Enscape, I'm going to be leaving a link down in the description of this video and then also up in the cards above. You can kind of test it out for yourself and see how you like it. So thank you for watching, and I'll of course be back with another Balkan Arctic tutorial in a few days. Have a nice day.